Good morning. This class we will represent the Dirac relativistic wave equation in covariant form. To make relativistically invariant, it should be represented in covariant form. Schrodinger's relativistic wave equation, it is second order in both time and space coordinates, and we have represented that equation in covariant form. Now we represent the Dirac equation covariant form. Dirac equation, the space and time components, time derivatives are appearing in first order form, and now we represent them in covariant form. We have the Dirac wave equation as E psi is equal to C alpha dot P psi plus beta m C square psi. Taking all the terms to left hand side, E minus C alpha dot P minus beta m C square operating on psi is equal to 0. This P, E we can replace by I h bar dou by dou t. The operator E is replaced by I h bar dou by dou t. And the operator P can be replaced by minus I h bar there. So this equation becomes I h bar dou by dou psi by dou t minus I h bar. So it will be plus I h bar c alpha dot del psi. P is replaced by minus I h bar del. Minus I h bar is constant, that is taken outside. So it will be plus I h bar then c alpha dot del psi minus beta m c square psi equal to 0, and this equation represents the Dirac wave equation for a free particle. Potential time is not present there. It represents the equation for a free particle. Now we will represent it in covariant form. This alpha dot del, we can write it as alpha x dou by dou x plus alpha y dou by dou y plus alpha z dou by dou z. And taking on minus, I am multiplying by minus beta by h bar c. I am dividing by h bar c and multiplying by beta, minus beta. This minus term will become plus, this will be minus, and this one will be minus. So this term is minus beta minus I beta by c dou psi by dou t, multiplying by minus beta by h bar c. Minus, to cancel the minus from here, I am multiplying by minus sign, then beta. This term beta into beta is beta square. Beta square we can take it as 1. To avoid this minus beta from here, I am multiplying by minus beta, then dividing by h bar c to remove h bar c from this term. So minus I beta by c dou psi by dou t, then here it will be minus h bar c will get cancelled, then minus I beta h bar c minus I beta alpha x dou by dou x dou psi by dou x dou by dou x plus alpha y dou by dou y plus alpha z dou by dou z. Then operating on psi. Then last term we are multiplying by minus beta by h bar c. So this term will be plus beta square. Beta square is 1. Then dividing by h bar c. C will get cancelled. So it is mc by h bar psi. Mc by h bar psi equal to, this term is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. I am writing this term here. Minus I beta alpha x dou by dou x plus alpha y dou by dou y plus alpha z dou by dou z operating on psi. Then first x1 is x, x2 is y, x3 is z. What is x4? The fourth space coordinate. We can take the three components as space coordinates and the fourth component as time coordinate. And in Minkowski space, the fourth dimension is represented by ICT. For representing this in covariant form, we have to represent x1 for ax, x2 for y, x3 for z, and ICT, x4. Instead of ICT, we can write it as x4. So this term, dou psi by dou of ICT, it should be ICT. For making it ICT, both the numerator and denominator, I am multiplying by I. If I multiply by I here it will be I square. I square is minus 1. So this minus will become plus. This IC is, I am writing this IC inside this dou. So it is dou by dou ICT of psi. So we can write it as plus beta into dou psi by dou ICT plus MC by H bar psi equal to 0. MC by H bar psi equal to 0. So this term we can write it as minus I beta alpha x dou psi by dou x1. Alpha x, I am writing it as alpha 1. So it is alpha 1. Alpha 1 is alpha x. Then the second term minus I beta alpha 2. Alpha x is alpha 1, alpha y is alpha 2, alpha z is alpha 3. Minus I beta alpha 2 dou psi by dou x2 minus I beta alpha 3 dou psi by dou x3 plus beta dou x by dou x4 plus mc by h bar psi is equal to 0. Now I am giving a substitution. Gamma 1 equal to minus I beta alpha 1 dou minus I beta alpha 1. I am substituting gamma 1 as minus I beta alpha 1. Then gamma 2, alpha 1 means alpha x. It is minus I beta alpha x. Then gamma 2 is minus I beta alpha 2 or minus I beta alpha y. Then what is gamma 3? Gamma 3 minus I beta alpha 3 or minus I beta alpha z. So this is gamma 1, this is gamma 2 and this is gamma 3. Then beta, instead of beta I am giving gamma 4. Now this equation becomes minus I beta alpha 1. This is gamma 1. So gamma 1 dou psi by dou x1 plus gamma 2 dou psi by psi, I am writing it last, gamma 1 dou by dou x1 plus gamma 2 dou by dou x2 plus gamma 3 dou by dou x3 plus gamma 4 dou by dou x4 operating on psi plus mc by h bar psi equal to 0. So this term we can combine using summation symbol. The first four terms we can write it as sigma k, sigma mu, gamma mu, dou by dou x mu plus these four terms, I am writing this one plus mc by h bar operating on psi is equal to 0. Sigma mu, gamma mu, dou by dou x mu. If an index is repeated, then the summation is performed over their index. So we need not write the sigma there because where the summation over mu is implied. It is Einstein summation convention. According to Einstein's summation convention, if an index is repeating, then the summation should be performed over the index. So the covariant form of Dirac relativistic wave equation is this one. Gamma mu dou by dou x mu plus mc by h bar psi equal to 0, or we can write this as gamma mu dou mu. If here dou mu is represented by dou x mu, gamma mu dou mu plus mc by h bar psi equal to 0. Either we can represent the covariant form by equation 1, or we can represent the covariant form by equation 2. So this represents the covariant form of Dirac wave equation.